Alex, we are back.
How you doing, brother?
Good, how are you, brother?
I'm good.
Good. Back again in the shop. The best barbershop in Toronto. That, the camera looks a bit crooked, so I'm gonna have to fix that quickly. But it's okay. Mm-hmm. You know, when you're doing content, like I always say before, sometimes things aren't perfect, you know? For all the people out there looking for the perfect angle, the perfect pose, the perfect business idea before you start, you'll never end up starting. Just start it.
Yeah, exactly.
What do you think about that? Is everybody looking for that perfect, the camera's got to be perfect, the perfect take, or, you know, I got to have the perfect business plan.
No.
What do you think?
It's usually the not so perfect things blow, you know, and they go the hardest. So you just have to go after what you want, you know?
Exactly.
Stop thinking about it too hard.
That's right. You know, it is complicated, but it is also very simple. You know, stop trying to, you know, put together all these plans and you haven't started anything. How about start something, and as you're starting something, the plans will come to you. Okay, that's not working. You make an adjustment. Let me try this. Let me do something different.
Yep.
But if you just plan all day, talk about it all day, visualize it on it all day, meditate on it all day, but there's no action behind it, nothing's gonna get started, right? So, you know, I'm glad that happened in the beginning of the video, because it shows that, you know, we're not perfect, but we're still shooting content.
Yeah.
It's not the perfect content. It's not the perfect angle. The volume might not be the perfect volume, because maybe you hear the clippers in the background, but it's about what we're saying. You know, the simple fact that we are doing this, you know, what matters most, I think. You know, it's action.
Yeah.
So that's so important. So I want to start the show off with saying, subscribe to the channel, hit that like button below. Remember, comment on the videos. If you want us to talk about anything in particular, comment if you're enjoying the videos, comment if you want us to discuss any other topics, if we're missing out on anything, or, you know, you want to get to know a little bit about me, a little bit more about Alex. But for our viewers out there, this is a barbershop, so I do come here, you know, I try to get here on a weekly basis. We do shoot these on a weekly basis. And I know these videos have been adding value to people's lives. And I just want to thank the people out there that watch this video every week. I get people that come to me and say, you know, we watched your barbershop series and it's inspired me to start walking, right? I had this one guy come to me. There's a story. And he watches every episode and he said he's made a lifestyle change. He walks now from, let's say, downtown to, I would say, Pape Village, which is about a 45-minute walk every time he finishes work. So he's watched the video and he wants to lose weight, and now he's inspired. So we've helped one person, you know, improve their life, and that's all I care about. Whether I receive a dollar, whether I receive one view, as long as I can help one person, and I think Alex, you can attest to this and say the same thing. As long as you're helping one person,
Yep. This
is very impactful.
Yep.
So Alex, how you feeling?
I'm all right, man. I can't complain. Just another day.
Yep.
Working hard.
It's good.
Trying to enjoy life.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's good. That's good. And where's the shop located again? Every time we come on the show, we want to remind people where the shop is, because it is a barbershop, the best barbershop in Toronto, a very hidden gem. But I believe in my mind, in a few years, this shop's going to blow up. The whole of Toronto's going to know about this shop.
Yep.
So where's the shop located?
So basically, I'm located at Markham and Lawrence. The address is 3482 Lawrence Avenue East. I'm unit 104. The shop is called Dollaz. And, you know, if you're looking for a good barber, looking for a clean barber, looking for a barber that gives you nice fades, clean lineups, and a good conversation, come check me out. My phone number is 647-466-1738. You can call or text and book an appointment anytime.
There you go. All right. Book your appointment. Don't miss out on the cleanest and best barber shop in Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe in manifestation. I believe that your words become power. And that's why I always say the best barbershop in Toronto, because I'm programming myself, Alex is programming himself, and we're manifesting the best barbershop in Toronto, because I believe in manifestation. And I believe you manifest things by your words and your actions. So Alex is doing the work, He's talking it into existence. He's doing the work. So why will it not happen for him? Mm-hmm. So it's also a belief system as well too. So if you're doing the work, if you're staying consistent and you're mastering your skill, perfecting your craft, why can't you be the best, you know? Mm-hmm. You're allowed to believe that. So as long as you're doing the work, you can't just try to manifest something when you're not doing the work. You actually have to do the work, because I want you to speak a little bit about this. Like manifestation, meditation, it's things that are trending, and I've had a lot of discussions with people about it, mm-hmm. and I think it's great. You know, I recently started meditating because it's clearing my head, mm-hmm. you know. But I believe those things work, like manifestation, when you work. So if I want to manifest something, if I just meditate on it, if I just pray about it, if I just think about it, I don't think anything's going to change. But if I do all that stuff and I do the work, mm-hmm. I believe things will change. What are your thoughts on that?
Of course, you always have to put the work into it, you know?
Yeah.
But speak positivity over your life, you know? Like, if you want something, tell yourself you're going to make it there, you know?
Right.
And always dream big, always be creative. And don't hold yourself back, you know what I'm saying? You gotta put that work in.
Right.
So yeah, like meditation, I'm not too into meditation. I'm not too sure what that is, but for sure, speak positively over yourself and work hard for what you want. And anything's possible.
That's right.
So don't make it seem like it's impossible for you. You see, everyone else do it out there. Why can't you do it?
Yeah.
You
know? And that's the mentality that you have to have. I love that mindset, Alex. Mm-hmm. That's why you're here in the shop, in your own barbershop, because you have that right mentality, you have the right mindset. Mm-hmm. That's why I call this channel Mindset TV, because everything is a mindset.
Yep.
You know, it starts with your mindset. Mm-hmm. Without the right mindset, nothing's going to get accomplished. Mm-hmm. So I like that, and never give up. And you know what? I like how you say, like, if somebody else has done it, why can't you do it? Mm-hmm. You know, if it's been done before, why can't you do it? Like, what's stopping you from, you know, getting to where you want to go or accomplishing the things that you want to accomplish? You know what's stopping you? You.
Exactly.
The person that you look in the mirror to every single morning. That's the only person stopping you. Mm-hmm. Nobody else is stopping you but yourself. Mm-hmm. So sometimes you just got to get out of your own way. Mm-hmm. You know, be truthful with yourself. I'm realizing the first thing is to always be truthful with yourself. Look yourself in the mirror. Did you give everything that you could today or yesterday or the next day? Are you giving everything you have, or are you going half and expecting results? Mm-hmm. What would you say to that person that, you know, they want a lot out of life, or they want to accomplish something, but they're not going that hard?
To me, like, it's easy to get fall off track, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you have to be a very organized person to, you know, you have to schedule yourself, organize yourself, because it's easy to be passionate today, and tomorrow you forget about what you're passionate about, you know? Because you're drowned out with all the distractions, and you're not really focused on the main goal, you know? So to me, you have to build a lot of discipline, a lot of organization, a lot of self-control, and really focus and dial in on what you want to do, you know?
Yeah.
So you don't fall off track. You don't forget what your goal is, what your mission is, you know?
Yeah.
So that's what I would say.
Yeah, that's great advice, man. Mm-hmm. And what I would add to that, too, is I find accountability is good, because, you know, if I didn't have Alex here, maybe I wouldn't be shooting these videos consistently. Like, it's good to have somebody else in your corner, or people in your corner that are either checking in with you or pushing you or working with you, you know? Like, I'll be the first to say it's hard to do it on your own, right? Like, when you have other people around you that are positive and like-minded, it kind of propels you and pushes you up, because every time I see Alex, he inspires me. Mm-hmm. Every time I walk in here and I see what he designed with his mind and what he created with his hard work, it inspires me to, like, continue to go. So I think getting around people that, you know, are doing things, people who have created things for themselves, it's always good to pick their brain, you know, and that's why I have this camera up, because, you know, Alex has accomplished some great things. It's just like, you want to learn from someone like that who's, you know, doing things that you want to do, whether it's, you know, you want to open up your own bakery shop, or you want to open up your own food store, or you want to be a content creator, right? All there's similar traits in entrepreneurs, right?
Yep.
Whatever it is. So what are some traits that, you know, that you have that you think people may have to develop if they want to be a full-time entrepreneur?
me personally, like, I'm a person, I don't take days off, you know? So yeah. if you're a person that works 1 week and has to take off a day next week or something,
yeah.
you have to come out of that, you know? Because me, like, I've been doing this for, like, over 10 years now.
Right.
And my only days off is if I'm going on vacation. If I'm sick, I'm still coming into work. If I don't feel good or whatever it is, I'm still coming into work. Because when you're self-employed, if you don't work, you're not making no money.
Right.
So you have to have a strong work ethic to begin with, you know?
Yeah.
And you need to be self-motivated too, because there's no one gonna push you to go to work and go hard and do what you gotta do. And when you're a business owner too, it's like you're doing 100 jobs in one, you know what I'm saying? Like right. You're the one promoting, you're the one working, you're the one cleaning up, you're the one dealing with money, you're the one dealing with phone calls, you're the one dealing with everything, you know? So it's stressful. So even being able to handle stress, you know,
yeah.
is something you need to work on too.
That's right.
But it's all achievable, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Once you focus on doing it,
yeah.
just go ahead and do it.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
It's all achievable. There's going to be stress that comes with it. And like Alex was saying, sometimes you might not be able to take a day off. So really, really ask yourself, you know, is being self-employed for you? Because it's trendy, and a lot of people talk about it, and people say, oh, be your own boss and ownership. And, you know, I'm pro all that stuff. But you got to look in the mirror and be real with yourself. Are you willing to show up when you're sick? Are you willing to work every day? If you're not, then it's okay, you know, working for somebody else. It's okay doing that. You know, it doesn't make you any less of a person because you're working for somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't believe that. You know, and anybody that tells you that, I can't support that. You know, you're still providing, you're still making money, you're still making an honest living. So I have to support you for doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody's mind's different. You know, some people's motivations are different. They want that because, you know, that's what, you know, maybe God planted in their mind. They want that because they want flexibility. They want that because they don't see a job that is for them, so they create their own. So don't just follow people and do it because other people are doing it. Do it because your heart and you have the desire and you feel like that's what you're supposed to be doing. Because, you know, like Alex said, there's a lot of stress that comes with that.
Yep.
Right? You know, there's no guarantee of your 2 week paycheck in your bank account. You know, and you don't know. 1 week it could be $100, next week it could be $20,000. You can't predict that. So know it's for you. Don't follow everybody else. Listen to yourself. Listen to your heart. And if you have a passion for something, go for it and create something with that. And, you know, we live in a generation that we talk about passion. And, you know, to me it's important to be doing something that you're passionate about, because it doesn't feel like work. So what are your thoughts on that statement, like doing something that you're passionate about because it doesn't feel like work?
Yeah, I believe everyone should do what they're passionate about, you know? Because even the other day I was talking to a guy and he was telling me how he was passionate about fashion and all these type of things. And after, he kind of gave it up. But like, it's still in the back of his head, you know? And he kind of wishes he never gave it up. So it's like, do what you want to do, because you're going to be at work wishing that you're doing what you're supposed to do, you know?
Yeah.
So to me, it's like, always go after what you want to do in life.
Yes.
You know? Life will make a way, you know?
Right.
But why be angry and miserable and sad and depressed at work when you know better and you know what you want to do? You just hold on to the job because it pays good or whatever. But at the end of the day, you're not happy.
Yeah.
So do what makes you happy.
Sure. That's great advice, honestly. Like, I tell you, every time I come here, I improve myself because I get this advice and I apply it to my life. And what I want to say here is application is key in the sense that what you hear on this episode, what you hear on this podcast, make sure you're applying it.
Because
you can listen to all these episodes. You can listen to all the greatest podcasters. You can listen to... You can read all the scripture you want. You can read all the books in the world. But if you don't apply what you're learning, nothing's going to change. So how important is application in life?
It's very important. That's probably the biggest thing in life, you know? That's a lot of people we don't do. Mm-hmm. You know, and we kind of sit back and watch the people that do it and marvel on them, like, wow, look at them, you know?
Right.
But the only difference is they're about the action and you're not.
That's right.
So turn your words into action, you know, and turn what you learned into action and apply it to your life, and you'll see how mountains will move.
Wow.
You know, and your life will change up real quick.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So turn your words into action.
Mm-hmm.
All right, the words that you're talking, start acting on them. The words that you're reading, start acting on them. Because that's when you'll begin to see the change.
Mm-hmm.
But there will be no change until you take the action steps necessary, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And when you do take the actions, don't expect to see results immediately. I think sometimes we get into this state of mind where we think we put 6 months of work in, but we're not seeing any results, right? Mm-hmm. Or we put 6 months of work in, and let's say we put 6 months of work into eating healthy and going to the gym and exercise, and we've only lost 5 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
And then we just say, oh, it's not working. Yeah, it is. It just takes time.
Yep.
Right? Your body's getting used to, like, eating healthy. Your body's maybe your body's different. So you have to eat different things. You know, maybe you have to experiment with something else. It is working.
Mm-hmm.
You know, stick with it. Yeah. You know, we want things too quick. And I learned that myself. Sometimes you want things to happen too fast.
Mm-hmm.
You know, stay patient. I think patience is very key. You know, I know it's a cliche thing that people say patience is a virtue, but mm-hmm. it actually is, because, like, you got to stay patient during the process, because,
mm-hmm.
you know, it might take 10 years. I read something the other day that said, I can't remember exactly, it was either Rick Ross or DJ Khaled or one of those rappers,
mm-hmm.
that they were in the game for 10 years and didn't receive a paycheck,
mm-hmm.
but they kept doing it because they loved it and they were so passionate. And in their mind, they knew by year 10, 11, 12,
mm-hmm.
that this thing would pay off.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not patient, you just give up,
mm-hmm.
then you're not going to see your dreams manifest.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think?
It's true. It's very true. Because even with me, like, I've been in this industry for a long time, and like me, I never gave up on it, you know what I'm saying? And I kept it going through the ups and downs, through the struggles. I just never quit. And then that's the thing, too, is never quit. You know, regardless of how it might look, because like you said, yeah, people that be doing it for a long time, probably making pennies.
Yeah.
After a boom, one day they blow up.
Yeah.
And now they're making millions, you know
exactly.
what I'm saying? So you give it some time. To me, it's not even about the money.
No.
But you want to be successful at whatever you're doing, you know? So just never give up, never quit, and keep pursuing what you got to do.
Yeah. Keep pursuing it, never give up, never quit.
Mm-hmm.
And like, I want to say this too, sometimes when you're on that path, you know, to going after the things you want, you may have to make short-term sacrifices. So
mm-hmm.
when I say that, I mean, you know, you might have to, like, you might hate your job, right? But right now it's allowing you to pay for your rent or your mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but when you're not there, make sure you're utilizing your time to build what you actually love or what you're actually passionate about. Because what happens sometimes is, you know, you hate your job, and then you go home and you turn on Netflix for the next 3-4 hours and you watch your Netflix series. But if you're not doing anything about your situation, nothing's gonna change.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you're watching the Netflix because you're trying to, you know, maybe suppress those emotions of hating your job, or you're not trying to deal with the fact that you hate your job, or you're stressed and you're like, this is a way to deal with my stress, or turn on my Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
But then you just go back to the same job that you hate the next day.
Mm-hmm.
So my advice, and I want Alex's input on this, for the person that, you know, is dissatisfied with their career or hates their job,
mm-hmm.
when you're not there, you know, figure out what you enjoy doing,
mm-hmm.
and do that. And even if it's like on a volunteer basis or it's not for much money,
mm-hmm.
later on it'll build where you can eventually leave that job. You know, so that's why I say it might be a short-term sacrifice.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so that's my advice, is like, get away from like the Netflix. And if you're happy with your job, fine, turn on the Netflix because you love what you do and you're, you know, you found what your passion is and you're doing it. But if you're not, for that person out there, my advice would be to turn off the Netflix while you're not at work. Make sure you're working on that craft, working on that skill, and just developing you know, spending 3-4 hours developing what it is that you want to be doing in the future, because it's so important. What's your advice for that person, Alex?
Yeah, I agree with you. And to me, it's like, get to look at where do you see yourself for the next 10 years, you know?
Yeah.
Do you see yourself in the same position, or do you want growth? So if you want growth, you can't be doing the same thing you're doing today and expect the growth, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You can't do the same thing, but just different results. Mm. You can change it up a little. So,
yeah.
Like you said, like put down the entertainment, put down the social media, and start learning. Start utilizing your time more properly. You know, stop wasting it. Cause all these TV shows, all these social media, they're not going nowhere. And really and truly,
true.
If you're not really making content, it's not making you no money.
Mm-hmm.
So. You stop wasting your time on it.
That's right.
If you're trying to grow and trying to improve yourself.
Yeah. Yep. Stop wasting your time on it if you're trying to grow and you're trying to improve yourself. And I'm not saying never watch it, you know, because we're not robots out here, you know. I don't think we're just meant to work 24/7. Still have that time for leisure and entertainment, but make sure you're not spending the majority of your time, like, we're doing that every single day.
Mm-hmm.
That's a problem. But if you, like, whatever, it's Saturday night or Sunday night, or it's one day during the week, you want to throw on an episode or a series, fine. You know, but if you're doing this every day and you're, like, you're expecting your situation to change,
mm-hmm.
then, you know, it's a little delusional. If your situation's not going to change, it's going to be, you're going to be in the same situation.
Yep. It's all about growth, too, because even like me, I used to smoke.
Yeah.
And I used to look at myself, I'm like, yo, do I want to be a 40-year-old smoker?
Exactly.
No, I don't want it. I don't want to spend the next 10 years smoking in my life. And I know, like, if I reach 40 years old, I'm still smoking. More like I'm going to reach 50 years old, and I'll still be smoking.
Yeah.
If I'm still smoking my 50, I'm going to be 60 still smoking. So
Whatever
bad habits you have from now, try to stop it from now.
Yep.
If you're trying to look at 10 years from now and looking at a better future.
That's right.
Begin, start from now and cut all the bad habits out.
Yeah.
So you grow, so your future looks more brighter.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Chop the bad habits off. Cut it out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if it's not, you know, making you a better person, if it's not serving you, if it's not, you know, assisting in your growth, you know, you gotta find a way to cut it off. And, you know, easier said than done, right?
Sure, yeah.
To cut off bad habits.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, you can do it. I believe in you. And if you need the support, send me a DM. Reach out to me. I'll try to help you with some of the bad habits. Not to say I'm some perfect human being, but I'll definitely help you with some of your bad habits. And use other supports. If you need counseling, Don't be afraid to step into counseling. If the habit is that, you know, ingrained or embedded, or it's an addiction, You know, seek some counseling. It's not a big deal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, seek help.
Seek help. You know, we all need help.
Mm-hmm.
Some way. But yeah, I just hope that, you know, we drop some value here, and, you know, this is just information that I've learned in my path and my journey. And I'm hoping that, you know, the thing I, like I said in a few episodes before, the thing I love about YouTube, the thing I love about content is this stuff lives forever, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we're gone, because we're eventually gonna be gone one day. You know, our kids can watch this stuff,
mm-hmm.
and they can benefit. And that's what I'm thinking about. I'm not thinking about this generation. I'm thinking about the next 5 generations.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they hear this stuff, and they're going to be able to apply it to their life, which is going to help them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this information is everlasting. It never dies, you know?
Yep.
The stuff we're saying here never dies. It applies to every generation.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm hoping that, you know, when I turn, or when I do leave the earth, that, you know, this information helps somebody else, and I know it is. And I really hope that it gets played, you know, maybe in schools. Who knows? You know, you don't know how much, that's why I say create content, because you don't know how far your impact can go. Because maybe not in this generation, but in the next generation, what me and Alex are producing here, they might show it in the classroom, because they're like, oh, we need a self-help talk.
Mm-hmm.
Let's play this. So they play what me and Alex were talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And then that inspires some kids to change their life, to drop their bad habits,
yeah.
whatever it may be. So be selfless sometimes. Don't always think about yourself. Like, it's important to think about yourself and take care of yourself, but think about if I'm doing something, is it benefiting something else? Us creating this is gonna benefit other people.
Yep.
So that's what I believe in. I wanna, you know, I feel like you know, for me at least, God has been a staple of my life. And you know, I have my days where I read my Bible, I have my off days. You know, I've been working on, you know, reading my Bible consistently. It's been a challenge. I won't come on the camera and say it hasn't been. But I believe that, you know, you got to have, like, something like maybe God or a higher being, something in your life that you're kind of following, you know, and letting guide you, like. Because if not, it's easy to fall to, like, listen to, like, social media or the TV or other external forces out there that can lead you. So, you know, I think I want to talk a little bit about God and how important it is to have God or higher being or power in your life. What are your thoughts on that, Alex?
Yeah, it's extremely necessary, you know. The thing is, God is the light of this world, you know.
Yeah.
So if you deny God or act like he doesn't exist, you can be living in darkness. You know?
Right.
So let God into your life and let him shine his light into your life. And man, not even for no money or for nothing like that. It's for you personally.
Yeah.
You know? Why live a lie? Why live in a lie? And why live in darkness when you can live in a light, you know?
Right.
So me personally, like you said, reading the Bible, stuff like that, that's what keeps me grounded.
Right.
That's my foundation, is reading the Bible, reading the Word of God, because that's the only truth on this earth, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Everything else is a lie. The only truth on earth is the Bible.
So yep.
Me, that's my foundation, that's my rock, and that's what keeps me grounded. Because even when I find, like, say, I don't read for a couple of days, like, I feel the battle, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
of course.
You feel the temptations, you feel everything. After you start reading the Bible again, after it brings you back. Basically, like, it shines light back into your life again, you know?
Right.
The darkness always trying to creep up on you and try to bring those temptations and try to recall it. Manipulate, try to, like, you know, control your thoughts. So reading the Bible, especially for me, like, it helps a lot, 100%. Mm-hmm. Builds up your character,
yep.
Makes you a stronger person. It makes you treat other people good. A lot of people are angry and miserable and they want to push it onto you, and after you, you could easily push it back. But evil, So someone does something evil to you and you do something evil back to them.
Yeah.
There's no purpose into that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I forgot to say, but basically, like, uh-huh. If someone does something bad to you, you do something good to them, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Don't repay evil evil.
There you go.
Repay evil good.
There you go.
But, like, a person who doesn't know the Bible would never think that type of way.
No. Yeah, it's good. It's great for you, like you said, your thinking and your, mm-hmm. you know, the way you approach situations in life. You know, when you have that word of God in you, you know, you think differently.
Yep.
So I think that's important, because, you know, you almost become what you read. Like, I'm learning that, like,
mm-hmm.
you know, it becomes a part of you, the things that you're reading. And in the Bible, there's a lot of positive things that,
mm-hmm.
you know, can really transform you as a person, can help you, you know, make a lot of better decisions in your life, you know. And I'm not saying it's an easy road, because, you know, you might start reading it and then it's dry, or you might start reading it, you might not understand what the words are saying, so you put it down. But
mm-hmm.
research it, you know, research and Google. We live in a generation where Google's at the click of like, it's right at our hand, you know. So it's mm-hmm. just like, just Google certain words, you get understanding. Because I think a lot of times, you know, when we don't understand, sometimes we just push it away.
Mm-hmm.
But find the time to understand what is being said, you mm-hmm. know, because if it's going to help you, it's good for you. So find God in your life, you know, and definitely open that Bible and start that journey.
Yeah, man, put God first.
Put God first.
Yeah.
So that's why I just wanted to talk about God. I never want to just leave God out, because, you know, I got to remember who gave me the power to have these words that I'm speaking on this video today. Mm-hmm. You know, I got to remember who's given me the ability to have a voice, who's given me the ability to have belief and, mm-hmm. you know, try to become a content creator, you mm-hmm. know, who's giving me that power, you know, so yeah. what's guiding me, right? What's giving me that hope and that faith, mm-hmm. right? Because it's easy to give up. Mm-hmm. It's easier to give up. Mm-hmm. You know, because you don't see results. You know, you're putting in the work, but nothing's happening. Mm-hmm. You know, but God says, keep going. God says, the journey's going to be hard. You know, God says, there's going to be a lot of trials, but I'm with you. Mm-hmm. Don't worry. This is what I have planned for you. Mm-hmm. So, you know, welcome God into your life. And I will say the positive thing about God, or the great thing is, you could have your back turned to Him, but when you turn around, He's facing you. Mm-hmm. So, as long as you may think you have your back turned to God, He never turns His back on you. Mm-hmm. So whenever you're ready to make that jump or that leap and commit to God, believe me, it'll be life-changing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're here in the shop, you know, get my hair cut, best barbershop in Toronto.
Yep.
You know, hope today we provided a ton of value and you learned something. And if you learn something, share it with someone else. Mm-hmm. I believe that. Do you believe that when you learn things, you should share it with
yeah,
other people?
Yeah, of course. Each one teach one, you know?
That's true. Each one teach one. I love that saying. Mm-hmm. You know. And I heard something amazing the other day. I heard you can learn from everyone. Yeah. Whether that be the homeless person, mm-hmm. your child, mm-hmm. your father, your mother, you know. You can learn from everyone, because mm-hmm. everyone gets life lessons, no matter who you are.
Exactly, everyone has their own story.
Everyone has their own story, so be open-minded to listen to that homeless person that's on the street or that homeless person that bumps into you and starts speaking. Don't be so quick to dismiss them and be like, oh, they're going to attack me or maybe they have a scent and you don't want to be around them. Maybe they've been sent to you to give you a lesson, because... You know, you're never too, what do they say, you're never too old to learn, and you're never too young to teach. Mm-hmm. So, be open-minded. What are your thoughts on being open-minded to everyone? Because everyone has a lesson.
Yeah, for sure. I remember I used to feed the homeless people downtown, and yeah. there's one guy, he used to be on drugs, and mm-hmm. we're there preaching the word of God, and he was preaching it back to us. But him, he actually memorized his Bible.
Wow.
So like, if I say the scripture, he'll finish it off. So just because they might be in a worse circumstance than you doesn't mean they're dumb. And it doesn't mean that they don't have God with them.
Yeah.
You don't have to think lower of them.
Yeah.
And like really and truly, in God's mind, the weak are strong and the strong are weak.
Uh-huh.
And the poor are rich and the rich are poor.
Uh-huh.
So God's really with those people if you really think about it.
Uh-huh.
The people that no one cares about, no one looks at,
but,
and they just pass judgment on,
uh-huh.
those who God cares about the most.
But,
so you can learn from everybody.
Great point. Learn from everybody. Everybody has a lesson that they can, you know, teach you. Be open-minded. We're all teachers, mm-hmm. is the way I see it. We're all teachers, because mm-hmm. we've all been through some type of experience. And we're going to continue to go through experiences in life. It never ends. Mm-hmm. It never ends.
Yeah.
Well, there's always something you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Les Brown, I heard him say, either you're coming out of a situation or you're going out of, or you're going into a situation.
Yeah, 100%.
So,
but that's growth.
That's growth right there. Yeah,
that's growth.
Yeah,
I feel like situations come to you because you need to deal with probably things you're fighting against. You know.
Yeah.
Or things you're struggling with.
Yeah.
So it's all about growth.
It's all about growth. So it's a lifelong journey.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we're gonna wrap the show up and. I just want to say subscribe to the channel, hit the like button below, and share this episode to a friend or someone that you think it could help them grow. Alex, it's been a pleasure as usual.
Thank you, brother.
Best barbershop in Toronto.
Yep.
Marcel, Mindset TV.
Yes.